circular motion? How does it work? Why did that ball start to move in a circle? Turns out, all you need to get something moving in a circle is a force on that object towards the center of the circle. In this case, the string pulls the ball into the center, forcing it in a circle. What would happen to the ball if it no longer felt the string's force? My friend Zena and I tested this by slicing the string with a knife. He set the ball in circular motion, and I sliced the string with a knife. That was fast. With no string pulling it to the center, the ball went straight up into the air. So, without an inward force, objects in circular motion would move tangent to the circle. Let's see that again. Without the force pulling it to the center, it goes straight up, tangent to the circle it was moving in. Let's write down some equations to see how this motion works. If you don't know all of the math I'm about to describe, that's okay. Just pay attention to which direction each thing faces. When this ball is moving in a circle, let's call its position p. It's convention to define omega as its angular velocity, angles per second. Let's say it took the ball t seconds to get to point p, so p is at the angle omega times t. We can break p into an x component and a y component. Since the angle is omega t, if we assume the circle's radius is 1, the x component is cosine omega t, and the y component is sine of omega t. Remember that the velocity with no strings attached faces tangent to the circle. Velocity measures how position changes with time. I'll write the velocity v based on how the position p changes in time. The x component of v has derivative minus omega times sine of omega t. The y component of v has derivative omega times cosine of omega t. See how v and p are always perpendicular. Let's calculate the acceleration on the ball from the string's force. Acceleration measures how the velocity changes in time, and it's pointed in the direction of the string's force. So the ball accelerates into the middle of the circle. The x component is minus omega squared cosine of omega t, the derivative of v's x component. The y component is minus omega squared sine of omega t. There are two key points. The only force on an object in circular motion is towards the center of the circle. And if you cut that force, the object continues moving in a line tangent to the circle. I hope you have fun experimenting with circular motion at home. You don't need knives.